My name is Muthu Bagavathiannan. I'm an assistant professor of weed science at Texas A&M College Station. We are in front of a USDA NIFA Foundation program funded project to look at multi-tactic strategies for integrated management of Italian ryegrass in wheat fields. The dominant wheat species in wheat is obviously Italian ryegrass in this region. It is a very problematic wheat species, shown to be very difficult to control. It has evolved resistance to multiple herbicide sites of action, including ALS inhibitors and ACCase inhibitors. There's also some recent reports of glyphosate resistance in this species, especially in a burn down situation. This is a large scale experiment. The total research area is about a little over 5 acres. You know, this has been ongoing for a 4-year period. In this 4-year study conducted across two locations, a standard as well as a diversified herbicide program were compared with and without harvest weed seed control in a split plot design. The herbicide treatments, which are the main plots, included a diversified program, that is axium tank mixed with zetua applied early post during late fall timing, which was followed by axial XL in the spring timing. And the standard herbicide program included prowl applied as a delayed pre-treatment.
As well as we included another treatment that kind of encourages wheat seed predation after harvest of the wheat crop. By not disking immediately after harvest, we basically allow the field to remain undisked for about a month, basically exposing the wheat seed for seed predators. We're hoping that it will reduce the amount of wheat seeds that go into the active soil seed bank.
At the end of the 4-year experiment, our results showed that narrow window burning combined with a diversified herbicide program provided actually the best Italian ryegrass control and a steep reduction in the soil seed bank. In plots with the standard herbicide program that didn't include harvest wheat seed control, there were approximately 60 ryegrass seedlings in a 10 square feet area, which was reduced to about 8 seedlings in the same area when harvest wheat seed control was integrated with the standard herbicide program. The delayed disking strategy was actually further effective in reducing above ground seedling densities. In this case, there were about 5 feet
in 10 square feet.
This is mainly due to an increased level of seed predation. So when house wheat seed control was combined with a diversified herbicide strategy, the ryegrass densities were very low. They were in fact under 1 seedling per 10 square feet area. Therefore, it's very clear that the use of harvest wheat seed control in combination with herbicides not only reduces Italian ryegrass infestations, but also protects wheat yields.